to West, with Al Malbridge and Nikolai Sage, and yes, it's all
I need it's gonna be our dear Maddie's birthday tomorrow. I wanted to step it up.
No, oh, I was so early with it.
What? What do you mean?
I texted him on the 15th. I was like, oh man, I meant to text you yesterday. Happy birthday, bitch. He was like, oh, you're early by a couple days.
What a shit friend.
I don't blame him. I don't have Facebook.
I was like, I thought it was the 14th, 15th. He's like, nope, 18th, 19th. I was like, oh, well, fuck you.
So not
that's
like, only...
That's exactly what I said.
So not only did you get the wrong day, because our friend Jack's birthday is today, 18th. And
right.
Then,
yeah.
And then Maddie Boy over here is the 19th. So not only did you get the wrong day,
I had the wrong order.
Got the wrong order. That's two strikes in one move.
It was not a strong play on his part.
I'm not good with birthdays unless it's like unless it's catchy, like a catchy birthday.
Ooh, 4.
I'll be
7.
Honest though, I don't. I don't think.
Nope.
It's a good date.
Wait, 4-7. Did you just say his birthday was August 2nd?
No, 4-7. Like that was a catchy number.
Yeah, that would be a catchy birthday, but that's not.
April 7th is a catchy birthday.
No, it isn't.
No.
He said it isn't.
It's a boring birthday. If you have that, I'm sorry for you.
Sorry. Continue, Matt.
Catchy birthdays are any with, like, an alliteration. Like, 1-11.
No. Ooh.
Or, like,
10-10.
No.
10-10-220.
No, I just wanted to shoot down the first one. I whatever it was.
What would you consider a catchy birthday, then?
I have no idea.
He's not going to tell us.
I have no idea what a catchy birthday is.
He doesn't
hear.
That's
good. At least you're critical of all of our answers then.
Yeah.
Well, I guess none of us have a catchy birthday.
And then I don't give answers, so nobody can be critical of me. Everybody wins. I'm going into politics,
everybody named
boys.
Seich wins.
Well, happy birthday, Matt, in the future.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, happy birthday, I guess. Well, now I don't have to text you tomorrow, so.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. Nothing has changed.
Yep. Congratulations on
and
leveling
we're,
up.
Well, I mean,
we're moving
it's not
on to Cincinnati. We're on to Cincinnati.
Ooh,
what is that? Oh.
The football coach. Yeah. Just packing it in, moving on.
You know
to
what?
The next
we went out there. We did our job. They did their job. And at the end of the day, you scored more points.
Yep.
Matt, I
can't look back on it now. The decisions that were made. And we're on to Cincinnati.
I like that you're always playing the Bengals next. What were you going to say, Al?
I thought Matt was moving to Cincinnati.
For a second there, I thought he was making a political reference, like that Cincinnati was the next primary, which it doesn't have one.
Ah.
Cincinnati caucus.
Yeah. The caucus.
Cincinnati.
No one really knows. Cincinnati.
And also, I would never... ever move to Cincinnati.
Why not? It's got the word sin in it.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome to Cincinnati.
I've been. It's very Manila. Vanilla. There we go.
Oh, I've been too. Jenny's from there. It's a lovely place. Would never live there.
Jenny.
No?
There's
no,
too little going on.
Jenny's from the block.
Got that right.
Yeah. She's still.
My sister-in-law is from there.
Don't be fooled by the rocks that she's got.
She's still Jenny from the block.
She's still Jenny from the block.
Yeah.
Yeah. Used to have a little. Now
she knows the best way to get shortcuts.
Yep.
Pretty sure that's not the next lyric.
Well, the producer took it out, so.
Pretty sure she knows where to get the shortcuts. It doesn't fit, no.
I'm pretty sure that's the music video that had Ben Affleck in it. You just see him look up at the camera and tilt his head like a dog.
Yeah, like, what?
What'd you say on that one?
What was that over there? Yeah.
I gotta go back to filming the hit film Geely.
Geely?
You said that and my stomach turned.
Yeah. Have you ever actually seen it?
Yeah, it's not good.
I haven't seen it.
It's,
no,
it's
I don't think
I feel like we should watch it.
I feel like you should go ahead and then we'll catch up.
Yeah.
No, I feel like all of us should watch it.
Okay.
Next time we're all home.
Yeah, Julie mandate.
Julie special. Oh, God. Oh, Matt. Julie. Matt's not hanging out tonight.
Matt's like, I'm sick for whenever this is happening.
Yeah. When is it? I'm busy, but when is it?
Yeah, I'm super busy that year.
Yeah.
The whole year.
It's 2/24/2021.
Okay.
So we're going to.
2/24. Okay.
So nice. February 24th, next year. Yeah, this we're is
gonna,
happening.
But, I mean, Matt's going to forget. And then.
That's true. I won't. Let me check this.
We'll trick him.
I'll never, ever.
Like, hey,
we're going to get you, Matt.
That.
I just bought.
I can leave Wednesday. After I get there.
Yeah, it's perfect. No, the door is.
I just bought a whole bunch of cheeseburgers and candy.
Crave case.
Why would you put candy?
Do you there's know a, candy? There's
no,
a.
Well, you know I'm not much of a sweets guy.
Someone chews.
You got me on the cheeseburgers already. Cheeseburgers I'm in.
Sorry, Al. Please go ahead.
Someone chews the food for you, Matt.
No. Why would you?
Oh, and then they baby bird it into his mouth?
Well, if he wants it, they don't have to.
They can spit it back onto the plate.
Yeah,
and
it's
he
a
can
choice.
Scoop it up.
Here's some used Starburst.
Well, they wear plastic over their mouths, and then they chew it, so it's okay.
None of this
so
sounds
they don't
okay.
generate any saliva.
Yeah.
That's smart.
That sounds terrible.
I can chew my own. Was that your selling point?
Well, one.
So in Al's mind, he's like, this guy doesn't like candy because of all the chewing. It's just too much darn work.
Yeah.
Guy, I want to be clear. Nikolai said he's going to get a bunch of cheeseburgers. I'm
okay.
in.
And Doritos.
All right. Ooh. I'm in.
With some dips.
I'm all double.
Right, I'm
multiple
in now.
Dips.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Wait, when is it happening? I want to be there.
It's 2/24/21. We're not going to be watching Geely. Wink.
Okay. I don't care if we're watching Geely with this. Multiple dips? You know how long I've waited for multiple dips?
There'll be a 7-layer, then just cheese dip, and then a French onion dip.
Dude, I love onion dip. Let's be real. I fucking love onion dip.
If you don't like onion dip, you're not American.
Oh, God.
Imagine if that was
it's a fucking hard stance to take.
So why aren't you friends with Nikolai anymore? Well, it was all of the onion dip.
I just wasn't an onion dip guy. It's a real bummer.
He kicked me out
he
of a party.
He wouldn't make it through that.
In front of everyone.
You hear Nikolai screaming off camera. You fucking believe this guy?
No, onion, like dip. Onion dip. I just take a handful of sour cream and slap him in the face.
Oh, my God.
Like Mike Epps in How High. I watched How High this week, guys.
Ooh. Like in that movie I watched.
Number 7, How High podcast.
Hell yes.
Yeah. There's a lot of competition. That's a great flick.
Yeah.
It's not. It has not held up well.
That's the one where they smoke the presidents, right?
Yeah.
What the fuck are you talking about doesn't hold up?
They smoke John Quincy Adams' finger at one point. It's ridiculous. Method, I always get their names confused. I'm terrible that way. But I believe it's Method, the taller one. Method Man, I believe. Anyway.
Yes, I believe he is the taller.
While flirting with the female lead, of the two. Just straight up grabs a titty.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, I was like, you can't do that.
I mean, you can.
No.
You just deal with the consequences.
That's true, but you certainly true. Shouldn't. You got to be invited to the titties.
Look, I want to be very clear. You can do anything you want as long as you're willing to deal with the consequences. There's no book.
It's true. That is
now
true.
I have to
fight there's
a
several,
pirate?
But you don't have to read them. That's the beauty of America.
Now, and well, I forget who said it, but you can do anything you want at least once.
Right.
Oh. That I know that bit.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. I know. I do remember that bit. I don't. I wish I knew who to give credit.
I think it
for.
Was. It was like, I think that was. Jack, said that.
It was, Jack.
Good old Jack.
Our friend Jack.
Yeah, our friend Jack.
Oh. He's dumb.
Oh.
He's
yeah,
dead.
I don't think he
no.
came up
no.
with that.
he might say something similar to that, but that we're referencing, we have seen a stand-up comedian do that.
Yeah. I would imagine most of Jack's life quotes are beer drinking related.
That's true.
Yeah.
Hey.
I could see Jack as the guy who tells, like, people that it ain't drinking in the morning if you've been drinking all night.
He should start selling t-shirts. That's what I should do.
He's very much like, you know how some people have like tattooed on their stomach, "Only God can judge me."
Yeah, yeah.
He has, "It's 5 o'clock somewhere."
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
I thought you were gonna say, "Only beer can judge me."
No,
oh, that's not
that's
bad.
That's good though.
That isn't bad.
Oh no, only God can beer me.
Oh yeah,
it's just God tossing him a beer.
Whoa, thanks, God.
Sorry, my hands are full, and it's just a picture of a guy with a beer in each hand.
Nice.
Like, it's just a whole bunch of stuff like that.
Yeah, yeah, it's all just beer quotes.
Yeah, and Jets related things.
Yeah.
Ew. Big Jets fan.
Ew.
How dare you?
What's up?
How effing dare you? You got the worst franchise in football the past 5 years.
All right, well, it's not about the present.
It's about let's the past,
go back what the fuck else is about.
Let's go back 15 years. Who's the better franchise over 15 years?
Yeah, all right.
All right.
Yeah, all right.
Hey, at least I got to see mine win two Super Bowls.
You want me to keep going, Nikolai?
You guys are just rude.
25?
You're rude people. You're rude people. I think at that point the sack exchange was happening. You know, when they still didn't win one? They just were good for 2 years.
I'm sorry if that was loud, viewers, but that got me so good.
Nah, you know,
they were good. They still didn't win one.
No. Let's go. Let's be honest. The Jets. Oh, God. I never realized that when I pick with my heart, it's always Pepsi for some reason.
Mm.
It's always Pepsi.
I can feel that way sometimes, but not always.
But I live in a state where, like, it's totally normal for me to root for the Yankees, but I would never fucking dare. And they're obviously
Coca-Cola. But
they're
so good.
The Yankees
Then the Giants, so obviously Coca-Cola compared to the Jets being Pepsi. Yeah, man. They're a much older franchise. They have way more championships, and they're much more well-respected.
Does that make the Bills RC Cola?
Oh, fuck yeah. That's Sam's choice, baby. Oh, shit. The four listeners from Buffalo are like,
Yeah. Hey, I resemble that remark. I don't know why Buffalo
people
sound like gnomes.
We went to four Super Bowls back-to-back. Just don't ask us about the outcomes.
I worked at the RC Cola factory for 5 years.
Oh, my God.
It was fine.
Yeah. It was fine.
It was just fine, though.
Yeah.
We got all the pop we wanted to drink. I didn't want any.
So much pop.
Coincidence.
That's the end of the story.
We used to dunk our lunches in the pop.
Who doesn't like a soggy sandwich?
Yeah. A soggy, now partially carbonated sandwich.
Yeah.
That's the best kind.
I like my bologna and cheese bubbling.
Yeah. Mm. And it's machined cola, so it's hot. It's
hot.
That's
a good point.
Yeah.
It's fresh, like piss.
That's how you get that hot bologna.
Hey, Ralph.
It's fresh, like piss.
How you get the bologna hot. Is that what you said, Sage?
Yeah, you get that hot bologna.
Hot bologna. That
Wait
sounds
a minute.
Like your Friday
you get the
night.
Hot bologna.
Am I right?
Yeah, because the soda's hot, he said. Hot bologna.
You wrap it around the soda?
No, you dip it in the thing. I don't know.
No, you dip it in the thing.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it was just for
I know what you mean.
I know.
Now.
You guys missed Nikolai he played out a rim shot on the desk with his fingers.
Oh, no.
After his hot baloney comment.
It's arguably one of the funniest jokes I've had on this thing.
Poor hot baloney.
Oh,
hot baloney sounds like your Friday night. I gotta tell you, I have been into a new breakfast food.
Okay.
I may have mentioned this a while back, but it's gotten to problematic points now. All right, you're all familiar with Spam.
Yeah, I've heard of it.
Yeah.
Okay. I've eaten it.
I've never had it, but it's in video games.
When I tell you boys that a fried Spam and egg sandwich is about the best goddamn thing you can eat in the morning.
I don't know.
You're gonna not believe me because Spam looks gross.
It does look gross. It's ham in a can.
But it tastes amazing.
Yeah, you get it all crispy on the outside.
Oh! Oh, it's like fatty, bacony deliciousness. I love it.
I've only ever had Spam on like Hawaiian pizza because I've had Hawaiian pizza and I like it and I know I'm not supposed to. Spam and pineapple.
Can like it. Hey, look.
It's American.
We'll see how many comments we get about that.
Some people have weird sex fetishes. Some people like weird pizza.
I think Krob likes pineapple on pizza. We're gonna find out. Let us know.
I mean, I've had it. I'll eat it if it's there, but
I don't know if
I'm
like
gonna
pineapple.
Ask for it.
I like pineapple on its own. To me, it just doesn't go with cheese.
Oh, it's the perfect. No, perfect is way too far. It's a great example of like salty and sweet.
I gotta try it.
Yeah, I've tried it.
Get a good salty slice.
You don't have
it. I actually don't think the cheese is as much the problem as the sauce.
Oh, okay.
The sauce for me does not play well. But anyway, everybody has different opinions. But at the end of the day,
go fuck yourself.
Say love it.
And eat Spam and fried egg sandwiches.
Because do you put that sounds
cheese
good.
On that bitch?
No.
No what? Cheese.
No cheese? Honestly, listen to me. The Spam is greasy.
Yes.
I'll be real.
Yeah, of course.
And you're frying an egg in the same pan you just fried the greasy Spam.
Yeah.
So you've got greasy egg and you've got greasy Spam. You don't need greasy cheese.
How do you make your egg?
I fry it.
Grease.
Crack it. Yeah, fried egg.
Okay. Yeah, I fried
on
egg.
Top.
Oh, yeah. Sides fried
eggs. Fried eggs yesterday. And I was like, yeah, I don't know if these are done. I might
how do you not
throw
know?
Up. I don't know.
I have no idea.
I always
idea.
Scramble them.
He asked me. I was like, they...
I would get eyes like not working?
I would get them scramby eggs. And
yeah,
then,
yeah. Scrambies.
Were they white?
Well, yeah. Well, I did the fried fucking...
Well,
I just
the bottom
fucking
was
cracked
like
it. I was like,
clack eye.
And then, like... Well, I didn't know if, like, the top...
Had
part,
to get brown
like
or something.
No, like the top. I don't know if it
well,
was
you,
if it was all white
well,
or if it was still
fried
jiggly.
Eggs.
Yeah, did you leave them sunny side up or
well,
did you flip them over?
No,
yeah.
Sunny
point?
Side up. I like that yolk running.
Oh, okay.
Running gotta catch all right, it.
Now it makes more sense. If you're gonna make them sunny side up, then you should put a lid over the top of them. Keep that steam in.
Oh, I don't got time for lids.
What? Yes, you do, man. Yes, you do.
I don't
listen,
know.
We were talking about hot bologna sandwiches before. When I worked at the deli when I was in high school, we had this guy, and we had a couple of characters that would come in. I feel like I've told some stories in the past. And this guy came in, and a very popular sandwich is a hot pastrami sandwich.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You heat up the pastrami. You get, like, rye bread and mustard, and sometimes you'll do it with or without sauerkraut or whatever. I believe that's similar to a Reuben, just not the same. This guy could not remember the word pastrami.
Mm.
And he ordered with great hesitation, I should say, and a lot of stumbling, a hot salami sandwich.
Oh.
And salami is a meat that is not meant to be heated up.
No.
Because it immediately becomes greasy and disgusting.
Oh.
So he got a hot salami and provolone sandwich.
Oh, no. Wait.
Disgusting. Wait. Oh, he was so drunk. It was noon.
Oh. Did he like complain?
No, he loved it. He ate that shit
he
up
loved
like
it
was loved it. He ate that shit up like it was a Spam and egg sandwich in the morning.
Nice.
Oh god.
Nice run.
You know that's a callback. Only one callback, Doug. Apparently
yeah,
his buddies
no,
are
oh, there's a callback fucking poser.
Oh. Poser. Get that done.
Yeah, but I remember that very vividly.
Man, at least, you know what? in our area, I'm just happy that he said the wrong meat, and he wasn't just like, hot Jewish beef.
Oh, God.
Because then you have to cut off the tip of your penis, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's a whole thing.
And that's
it's a
like,
service industry, man. The customer's always right.
Yeah. Chop it off. Serve it out.
Just whipping out. Is there a name for that? Well, foreskin. Duh. Just whipping out foreskin sandwiches left and right.
Yeah, it's a delicacy. You got to pay extra.
Well, yeah, you got to pay a lot for that.
I don't have to talk about this.
Well, and Nara left.
If fried, resemble calamari.
I was just about to say, well, you don't like fried calamari anymore? No.
Fried calamari is good.
I've never liked it.
It depends on the place.
I don't like too rubbery.
If it's rubbery, it's not good.
Go to Outback Steakhouse.
Nope. What? Nope.
Why is that always your go-to? Does your family go to Outback Steakhouse? I feel like you've brought it up a couple of times. You're always like, Bloomin' Onions this. Outback Steakhouse that. Crikey.
You do say crikey all the time.
That's my impression of you, Al. I feel like there was two of us there for a second.
Yeah, I was like, wow. I do like Outback Steakhouse. I don't know. Maybe I'm going to surprise you one day.
Okay.
Outback Steakhouse.
I would love a surprise trip to Outback.
I have been twice, and both times I did not enjoy it.
What?
Same really? For Chili's. Been to Chili's three times. All three times,
yeah,
something happened.
Chili's
okay, well, Chili's is garbage, but then we're Outback. We're talking about Outback here. What did you get? You remember?
Yeah, like I think I got like a sirloin with some mashed taters the first time.
Oh, that's the problem. You don't go to Outback for the steak. That's your first mistake. Don't look at the part of it that says Outback Steakhouse.
Outback House.
Well, what happened?
That was a big boy.
Bug?
Oh, there's a bug in here. And Matt.
I honestly didn't see what it was until it crawled under here.
Yep. It's not where it was. I can tell you that much. What did you say, Al?
Me. Where am I? It's me. The bug.
We'll hope and pray. So the bounce shot.
I did. It was more impressive that the shot bounced than if it had just gone in.
You got me.
Oh, I got the bugs back.
That really did scare the shit out of you.
It looked bigger than it was out of the corner of my eye.
Yeah, I've heard that
before. It looked
before.
Bigger than it was, all right? Wow.
I hear you, Matt. I don't like bugs.
Oh, we know you don't like bugs, Al.
Yeah, bro. I'll bring a bug in a box to Outback Steakhouse. We'll have some.
What?
You get a free meal?
No, just to look at it.
Just open the box a little bit.
Yeah, we're
like,
still
ugh.
Paying. Yeah.
This Sorry, is my friend.
You can't bring that bug in here.
All right, we'll do it in the car after.
just look at it in the car.
Now you're just making looking at a bug sound like we're going to do drugs.
Yeah,
but we're not. We're just looking at a bug.
Look at this bug, bro.
Gentlemen, you can't. Out. You cannot bring a bug into the restaurant. It's all right. We'll just do it in the car and we'll be right back.
Hey, bug pass, man.
Hey-o.
You saw that, right?
Matt's that's the kind of guy you want with you in the trenches.
He's coming right for
you
us.
Know when anything is bad, it's going to happen. It's coming right for us.
I'm going to freak out about it, and I'm going to be shitty about it, too.
Oh, you want me to shoot back, do you?
Oh, yeah. Oh, you just want me to casually take a life? Like, it's so easy. Thunk. Oh.
Be like John Boy from All Quiet on the Western Front. Spoilers.
Oh, spoilers tagging a, what, 65-year-old movie?
No. At least 50 for sure. I mean, if you're into World War I movies, that are about the Germans.
It's my thing.
I just love their perspective of the war.
Yeah.
You they know, had a lot of horses. Right one, I like the horses.
I like the horses.
I like their sure helmets. No they look like flick. Knights.
There we go.
It's like a night war.
Night war. You know. Like any of the wars during the medieval times.
Yes.
When they were actually using knights.
And horses.
You know, not the one yeah. where they were using mustard gas.
No, they were.
I'll throw some mustard gas just for, you know.
No, no, I'm saying the medieval ones.
Oh, yes, my mistake. They were using dead calves.
That's true. They were catapulting dead animals into besieged castles.
You know, you do what you gotta do.
Yeah, exactly.
They would tip arrows in dead bodies.
Really?
Yeah. You would tip an arrow in dead bodies, and that way you didn't have to worry about hitting center mass. Even like a leg or an arm shot could be fatal because of the infection.
Yeah, it makes sense. I know Al already said it, but this is a perfect time for a welcome to RLF.
Yeah, bro.
A second. Welcome to the midpoint of RLF.
RLF.
We're 20 minutes in.
Right around the next corner, we have the comment section.
That's true. Or left-hand turn, movie talk.
Ooh, okay.
Movie Did you guys watch any movies this week?
Let's do
Not
it.
A whole bunch, no.
I watched zero movies.
I didn't watch any movies. Did you watch a movie, Nikolai?
Of course I did. Did you call me Nikolai?
No. Nikolai. Oh, I'll go back. I'll check.
Right now. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, I watched like a bunch of movies, actually. But... how about you, Sage? Did you watch any films?
I watched zero movies.
You watched Stranger Things.
Yeah, I went through Stranger Things. I'm all done.
Well, that's a television show. You can talk about that.
People have talked about it.
It's been done
now that we already know the answer. Do you think Hopper's dead at the end?
Who knows, dude?
Yes. Yes, that's second Hopper.
That's John Hopper.
That's
John Hopper. So I went on a little bit of a like a very mini Will Smith marathon.
Ooh!
I watched.
Oh,
Men
you got
Black
jiggy with it.
Get jiggy with it. Anyway, watched Men in Black.
Nice.
Because we are the Men in Black.
Classic.
Right.
Galaxy Defenders.
Yeah.
Of
course.
What year do you think that movie was?
96.
Oh. Nah, yeah, I was going to say like 97.
I'll say 96.
Matt.
Yeah.
Matt hits the nail on the head with 97.
Oh, Matt stole
my answer.
I really
thought that movie was like 2000 for some reason.
I don't know, it's the good 90s.
I remember it being earlier just because I remember watching that very young.
Okay, yeah.
So
it's great. That movie holds up.
Oh.
Holds up so well.
It, sure.
Most of it does.
I mean... You're talking about the CGI?
No.
It's
a very entertaining movie. No, the CGI is like, the puppets hold up well.
Yeah, that's true. But, no, the actual like story arc, absolutely.
Yeah, exactly.
Because it's a retirement arc.
Yes.
Yeah. It's a very, like the hero story, it's a very common trope, but they did it really, really well.
Yes.
And the setting they provided was great. They made the two characters super interesting.
Oh, exactly, yeah.
The
lady coroner is pretty great, too.
Yeah.
Who played her?
Oh, I couldn't tell you.
The chick from Dogma.
The chick from Dogma?
Yeah.
Sage said.
No way.
Betty
oh, my
Jones.
God, it is.
I don't know what her name is, but...
Yeah, I couldn't... Like I said, I couldn't tell you. But you're right, it is the chick from Dogma. That's pretty cool. I also watched a movie called 7 Pounds from 2008.
Oh, that's the meat one.
Yep.
Yeah, Will Smith plays a downtrodden meat vendor. No. No, it's way more depressing than that. He was this like hotshot engineer, and spoilers, everybody. He gets into a car accident and kills 7 people. So then he has to save 7 people's lives by donating organs. And the end of the film... He kills himself with a jellyfish.
Yep.
With a jellyfish?
Yeah,
the
you heard me right.
Deadliest creature on Earth.
Yep. They say that in the movie. I don't believe it is, but they say that in the movie.
Do they really?
I'm pretty sure sharks and polar bears have something to do with it.
You put a shark and a polar bear up against a jellyfish, and we'll see what happens. Yeah.
Oh, my God. The jellyfish has murdered everything. Jesus Christ.
And so I've got 2 more. I watched an absolute 80s classic that you guys are going to be excited about.
Nope.
It's not the Goonies.
Yeah, we know. No, of course it's not.
We get the bit at this point.
Yeah, it's true. Can't
we
buy,
still hate it.
Can't buy me love.
Don't even. Who does Will Smith play in that?
No one. No one. There's no. There are no black people in this movie.
Oh no.
It's 1987. It's Patrick Dempsey, and they're. I think they're in. I know they're in California, but I don't know where in California. But it's very wealthy, because the houses are enormous. But basically, he pays the head cheerleader and the like, the most popular girl in his grade,
mm-hmm.
to pretend to be his girlfriend for 4 weeks,
okay.
so he can become popular himself.
That's a lot of money.
Yeah.
Oh, it's Easy A from the boys' side.
Yeah, but it's also like 20 years before Easy A.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So Easy A is Can't Buy Me Love from the girl side.
Kind of. they redid it. They did a black version with Nick Cannon in the early 2000s.
Wow.
It was pretty good.
Cannot just say
what?
A black version.
They did. It was. There's no white people
wow.
in it. I'm I don't know. It may have been the same name, too. But anyway, that one is probably better. Because this one, it's not great.
Who would have thought the
it's
Dempsey
good.
Led...
Well, first of all, they do that classic movie thing where they put glasses and a schlubby t-shirt on a smoking hot chick, and then they're like, oh, no way, we made her gorgeous, like, by taking the glasses and schlubby t-shirt off.
Oh, yeah.
So it's just Patrick Dempsey with a goofy haircut and bad clothes and glasses. Then she takes his glasses off, pushes his hair the other direction, and rips the sleeves off his shirt. And every girl is like, who's that?
Wait, nice. He has muscles?
Yeah, exactly.
All it took was a little bit of fashion. So, you know what, Nikolai? I think you owe the class
mm-hmm.
a 300-word essay
oh,
on
sure.
why you chose the Patrick Dempsey 1987 classic
yeah.
Can't Buy Me Love over the Goonies.
Because it was on HBO this month.
You know what? That I'll take it.
All right.
He doesn't need the rest of the words.
That's really all it is.
Because it was on HBO this month. That's
I've got,
seven.
I've got like 2,993 left.
Oh, man, you're writing a 3,000 word? I said 300.
Oh,
let's
my
go.
Goodness. You said writing a dissertation on why I watched Can't Buy Me Love. I did notice something, and I hope I'm correct when I say this, that I found very unique about this rom-com. Because, of course, you guys are going to guess what happens. She ends up actually kind of liking him.
No.
He becomes popular. Then
what?
Becomes a jerk. And then it all goes to hell. And then they end up together in the end. At no point do they share a kiss.
Nice.
Hey.
I was like, oh,
let's
wow. Because the movie ends with her jumping on the back of his rider mower. Because that's how he earns cash.
Another thing now was. That Adam Sandler stole.
What?
Waterboy.
Okay.
It was a bad joke.
I liked it when you explained it.
That's always, that's always when jokes are the best.
I don't know. This movie sounds intriguing.
No.
I honestly didn't love it. No. I liked it. It was, it's good.
It's passable.
I gotta be honest. A couple weeks ago, I rewatched Pretty in Pink.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed Can't Buy Me Love way more than Pretty in Pink.
Oh.
That movie, like, I did not enjoy Pretty in Pink. Ducky just made me uncomfortable.
Yeah. It's very, very
Ducky
out
kept
of place
staring
movie
at me.
Nowadays.
Yeah, right? the last thing I watched this week was, before I go forward, any more questions about Can't Buy Me Love?
Oh, no. I'm good.
Yeah,
oh.
I'm good. I'll pass.
Louise.
But most of my questions revolve around some form of the Goonies, so I'll just hold off.
Well, Josh Brolin isn't in this film.
No, I know. Patrick Dempsey is.
That's true. That's
we
correct.
Went with the Dempster.
Oh, yep. There's this great moment where Dempsey is hanging out with the jocks, and it's Halloween, and they always destroy or egg the same house every year. And you get to the house and bum bum bum, it's his old best friend who's a nerd's house.
Oh gosh.
Yep.
Oh
yep.
Man.
Gotta throw those eggs, pussy.
But it's not just eggs. They got an entire bag filled with dog shit.
Oh my god.
That's a lot of dog shit.
It's so much dog shit. Like, the idea of them collecting this much dog shit.
Do they have gloves on? How are they throwing it?
With his hands. I mean, it's in a bag, but it's you just throw the bag.
It's the 80s.
With your hands.
You can get shit on your hands in the 80s.
So then you
fine.
Just pick up.
I mean, all you see is the outside of the bag. There's no doo-doo on the bag.
No. They just rubbed all on the outside of the bag. It's a mess. It's a mess.
So, one of the pieces of exposition are that they're ready at the house to be attacked because they do this every year.
Right.
So that the father has set up, like, a net. Yeah.
A doo-doo net.
I'm sorry.
Doo-doo net.
I'm sorry. Hold on. Like, a net as in to catch these wascally rabbits?
I'm going
to
catch one of these kids this year.
Oh, my God.
It's not going to happen again. It's not going down like this. Stay golden, pony boy. We're doing it for Johnny. All that stuff.
We're doing it for Johnny.
So, does Wile E. Coyote manage to catch one of these kids?
He does, but you'll guess which kid he catches.
Oh, is it Dempsey?
It's Dempsey.
Oh,
how could
idiot
you have fallen
Dempsey.
This far, son?
The dad doesn't catch him. The older son, who's Dempsey's former best friend, does. He lets him go because he's so in shock that his friend would throw dog shit at his house.
Right.
Just to try and appear cool.
Oh, man.
So, the next time you see them... The movie does a horrible job of explaining time. It just goes from like, oh, it's Halloween night, to like, boy, Thanksgiving dinner was so good. What the fuck just happened? So, like, they're getting back from Thanksgiving break, which is the next fucking scene, which was confusing Damn. For a second.
Yeah.
And he sees his best friend in the hallway who is giving him the cold shoulder. And the last bit of dialogue is he goes, how long are you going to be mad at me over this for? Because you're like, it's the first time they referenced how much time has passed since right. Halloween. Later on in the movie, he runs into him in an arcade. Now, this is after everybody has found out that, like, what he did, and the school immediately hates him again. And they're in the arcade, and he's trying to talk to the best friend character, and the best friend grabs him by the collar and slams him up against one of the games and screams, "You shit on my house! You shit on my house!" I was laughing so hard. And it was such like an emotionally raw moment. But the idea of him saying it, that, like, because he didn't shit on his house.
No, he threw shit at him.
Exactly.
He didn't pull his pants down. Here we go.
Oh, you could have watched the Goonies. You could have watched the Goonies.
Oh, but Patrick,
you shit on my house!
Patrick Dempsey never says die.
No.
You shit on my house.
Oh, man.
You shit on my house!
So the last movie I watched this week was Harley Quinn, Birds of Prey.
How was
it's
that?
It's on HBO this month.
I'm sorry.
I gotta be honest. I liked it.
Okay.
Was it great? No.
I forgot.
But
that
I thought it was good.
Nice.
I thought it was good.
I had heard poor things. I had not seen it. So.
First of all, it's an R, and the violence is there. There's no like nudity or anything like that. But it's so it's not like a hard R by any means. Right. But it certainly earns its R with the violence that's in the flick. Ramona Flowers is in it. She's great. She plays Huntress. What else? The one big critique I had, and this is super fanboy, my favorite B villain in the Batman Rogues Gallery is Victor Zsasz.
Okay.
It was one of the only reasons why I even watched parts of season 2 of Gotham. I really enjoy that character. I like how much of a psychopath he is. I like the idea of him constantly cutting himself every time he earns
God,
a kill.
That's crazy.
I am crazy. I am a little... Don't you ever forget it. They made the character... Or they made the choice to have that character be the henchman, but also gay lover for Black Mask. Now, at no point do they kiss or anything like that, and I don't give a shit that they made them gay. I actually kind of thought it added another layer of depth to... It gave Ethan... Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Supply?
No.
Ewan McGregor.
Ewan McGregor. I don't know where Ethan came from.
I was like, Ethan Suplee is not in this movie.
He gave Ewan McGregor something else to do. Like, because his character's pretty obviously gay. But the idea of Victor Zsasz, who's played by Chris Messina, who I only know from, like, rom-coms as the boyfriend or the friend of the boyfriend. And so he just doesn't seem maniacal to me in any way.
Right. He does not scream serial murderer. Who cuts his own body every time he kills someone.
Exactly. Yeah. Like, the makeup was decent. It was okay. But he just... It wasn't the right... It was like watching the guy who played Cyclops in the original X-Men movies from 2000s.
What was wrong with the Cyclops?
Oh, I hate... That guy's... Oh, okay. I thought you were serious for a second. But yeah, besides, that was my only critique, was that, like, Zsasz just didn't work for me. It didn't also need to be Zsasz. It just was for the sake of it being Zsasz. Like, I love that the Joker and Batman are not in the film at all. Love
that's
that.
A good decision.
Love that. And I thought Black Canary was really good. So, it was a decent movie overall. It was.
I'm glad you enjoyed it. I have not seen it. I had only heard, you know, terrible
I'd
things.
I'd like to watch it.
Especially about the scene where Harley grabs Huntress and she's like, "You shit on my house!"
You shit on my house! Now, I just, well, I'm comparing it to, like, Batman v Superman and Justice League. So, in the DC Universe and Suicide Squad... It is so much better than Suicide Squad.
Like, that's good.
It as far as the DC Universe goes, it's above average. I'll say that.
Okay.
Doesn't even compare to a Marvel movie. Doesn't.
Well, come on.
If it was a Marvel movie, it's like Iron Man 3.
Honestly,
which I liked a lot.
Iron Man 3 wasn't that bad.
I like Shane Black though.
Everybody shit on that movie, and it's like,
you shit on my movie.
you shit on my movie. nobody really liked that movie because of the Mandalorian. It wasn't even the Mandalorian. We didn't even see the Mandalorian.
Mandalorian.
That was the weirdest crossover. Maybe although they are both owned by Disney, so. Who knows? Maybe in the future. Maybe Woody from Toy Story joins the Avengers.
Oh my god, I was gonna say, like, the child is at a camp is an Easter egg in one of the moments.
the Mandarin, everybody, it was a fake out, and I was like, yeah. So what? It was a fake out. The Mandarin is a character who uses 10 magical rings.
Yeah, right.
They have almost completely tried to avoid magic per se in the Marvel Universe. Like,
Until Doctor Strange.
I'm sorry?
Until Doctor Strange.
They even tried to avoid it in Doctor Strange. I mean, they couldn't.
Yeah.
But at the same time, they were like, people would call them spells. If that makes you uncomfortable, call them equations. they tried to
code behind the world, Bobby.
But yeah, it was. I don't think it was as bad as everyone said.
Oh yeah, definitely. So those are the movies I watched this week.
Nice.
Yeah, I watched all of Stranger Things. Like, that's done.
Nice.
How do you feel about season two after the rewatch?
I like season two.
You skip that episode.
I always skip the that one episode where she goes to the other sister.
Why?
I hate it. It's just you don't need it. I don't need that episode. Nothing happens.
You don't need it. They clearly put it in there. Just listen. It'll probably pay off in the future.
Yeah.
At least you hope.
And like
maybe
it paid off in the comics. They kind of like
you
a
watch
really
it once.
Oh, really?
And it's fine. Like, you don't need to watch it again.
Yeah.
There's no singing in it.
Nope.
Actually, season one is still the best season, though.
I love
the problem for me with that episode where she goes to see her sister.
Yeah.
Is at no point in the episode do you believe Eleven's about to kill this dude.
Yeah. Yeah.
At no point do you think that this dude is in danger of dying.
Yeah.
So it's like, All right.
But it is a nice random 80s flick in the middle of the series. It's an 80s romp in the middle of the series. Whereas all of season 3 is an 80s summer movie.
Yeah, I love season 2.
I love season 3. I've watched it so many times. In season 2, that one episode is like a nice mini romp.
Yeah. Quick, everybody. We're going to do a Natural Born Killers for one episode.
Yeah,
we're
right?
We're just going to drive around.
Oh, man. So do you guys want to listen to Tommy Gunn sing? Do some comments?
Probably not.
All right. Fuck it.
All right. Well, if you need a gun, then that's it.
The videos on YouTube have a place called the comment section where people can type out heartfelt and thoughtful reflections of the videos they just watched. Like you and I were left on Wednesdays. Now the gang will read a few. It's really hard to rhyme the word Wednesdays.
Oh, wow. Beautiful.
Oh, wow. Wow. Last week we were talking about Forrest Gump because Seich and I watched it like 6 times.
Oh, dude.
And it's one of the best movies
speaking
ever.
Of Forrest Gump,
oh.
I just watched something on the YouTubes today. It was like behind the scenes shit.
Behind the scenes of Gump.
From, like, filming.
Oh, wow.
It's pretty cool.
That's cool. Was it interesting?
Yeah, dude. It was pretty good.
I was watching it from my room. It was pretty cool.
Pretty crazy.
So did you guys, like, start the videos at the same time, or was he watching
the
living room?
No, I watched
it
in my doorway. In between.
Yeah, no, I started watching it earlier, and then I finished it out here. And he watched the end of it. It was all right.
The end.
Our first comment this week comes from Antilicus. There's a novelized sequel to Forrest Gump titled Gump and Co., describing Gump's further historical misadventures and his interactions with his son, who is actually very precocious and intelligent. A prodigy even.
Gump? Huh. Gump and Co.
Gump and Co?
Gump and Co.
Are they selling
That's
pretzels?
That's an atrocious name.
Yeah.
But... Was Forrest Gump the movie originally a book too?
I think so,
yeah.
But I think like the books get weird, or at least like Forrest Gump the book is doesn't get. I think we have talked. He gets stuck on an island with like a monkey.
Yeah, the books were weird. Once they got into time travel, it was.
Oh God! Yeah, the Terminators.
He went back. He was the one who killed Lincoln.
Yeah. He's John
I met
Wilkes
the president
Booth?
A fourth time. I shot that one in the back of the head.
I said, I'm tired of this, and you ain't got no Dr. Peppers.
I said, there's no Dr. Peppers accident. In the 1870s.
I gotta pee.
The devil said, you only way to get back to your present time is to kill the president.
Oh, my God.
Wow. I said, okay, Mr. Devil, I do miss my Jenny. Yeah.
I gotta get back to Little Forrest. He's gotta get to school.
Oh, Gump.
Alright, so if we want to learn more about Forrest Gump and his misadventures, we should read Gump and Co.
Gump
Thank
and
I
Co.
will never read it,
Thank you.
But somebody tell me about it.
Brian the Great writes, also, I'm not gonna lie, Matt, I've also watched documentaries to get ideas for D&D.
Boop, see, it's not the worst thing.
You're not alone.
I'm glad to hear that, Brian the Great. It wasn't very useful to me because I did lose the war campaign that I was researching.
Oh, no.
But it all works out.
How? And what do you mean you lost it? Like you're not going to do it?
No. I mean, the last episode of the campaign that we played, I my team lost.
Oh shit!
We got overrun.
Oh, you're terrible.
We had superior numbers, but we were trying to siege a well-fortified tower.
Oh, you're so bad.
Thanks, Sige. I'm glad you repeated it.
I didn't know you called him bad.
So it's lost in time.
No. I heard you.
You
say
called
it the first
me bad
time.
Twice.
Oh, yeah.
You're a cunt.
Well, I think
that
have
was
to,
his birthday gift to you.
I have to keep letting you know.
Oh, thanks.
And a lot of comments from Matt this week. Shane Keys writes, "Here's a cat fact for you, Matt, to share.
Ooh,
one of the most unsuspecting members of the feline family is the hyena.
See, that makes sense because hyenas can't roar.
They're always laughing.
They're laughing.
I knew hyenas were part of the cat domain.
I didn't.
Oh, really?
Were they like a cat-dog hybrid?
Cat-dog.
No, they're just
cat-dog.
Just a cat.
Alone in the world with a little cat dog?
Yeah. One fine day with a wolf and a purr, a baby was born and it caused a little stir. No blue bunny, no three-eyed frogs, a feline canine, little cat dog, cat dog. Woo!
I cannot believe you remember that whole thing.
Second verse, too.
All right, so that's pretty cool. I didn't realize that. We're learning. Thanks, Shane.
I don't like learning, Shane.
Yeah. Cat facts. That should be a new... Like we should have like a
cat facts with Matt
sound for that. Cat facts with Matt's.
Cat facts with Matt.
Bang. Our final comment this week, for me at least, is from Brittany. She writes, "I love that Street Fighter was mentioned. It's my favorite movie that I know is horrible, but I love it anyway. I love it anyway. Movie LOL. Fun fact: apparently, Jean-Claude Van Damme was coked out of his mind during the filming of it. I also need more of you guys talking about Disney movies. Moana is amazing."
Oh.
Nice.
I mean, it wasn't bad.
Well,
I did enjoy it.
Honestly, it does not surprise me that JCVD would get a little cocaine up in his system.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, I mean, come on.
That doesn't strike me as odd.
It was the 90s. Come on.
Yeah, come on.
I think, right? When was first Street Fighter? Who knows?
It had to be the 90s. Yeah, it had to be the 90s.
Yeah, it wasn't.
Like 97, 98 maybe?
Wait, is Jean-Claude Van Damme in Street Fighter?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who is he in Street Fighter?
He's
the main guy was that Asian guy.
He's the stretchy guy.
Guile, right? He's Guile?
No, Zangief.
Nope. I don't think he's Zangief.
He's not Zangief.
He's Zangief.
I have no idea who he is.
Hold
on. The main
Let me look
guy
it up.
Was the guy who was in Beverly Hills Ninja. R.I.P. Chris Farley.
Chris
Farley.
Yeah, he's Colonel. He's Colonel Guile.
Oh, okay.
He's Guile. So in the video game, Guile had the spiked up like blonde hair, flat top.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's been a while since I've seen that movie or played ever. I don't think I was ever into that video game. I went from Nintendo, like original NES, to PlayStation 1. So like I missed like a whole generation.
Right,
of video
you jumped
games.
Over.
Yeah, I never had a Sega. Didn't go to the arcades a lot at that point in time.
Oh, shit.
Except for Nathan's.
Well, now I'm just looking up Street Fighter facts.
Well, sure.
The lady who played Chun-Li, Ming-Na Wen.
Yep, sure.
Is
I knew that.
Is also in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Oh, that's cool.
She's, yeah, I didn't know it was
Agent Cody Banks?
Agent Cody Banks, Matt? What was it?
No, not Agent Cody Banks. I will never talk about Agent Cody Banks.
Why would you bring up Frankie Muniz? You know how he gets.
I did.
Oh! Frankie fucking Muniz. Still owes me $200.
Oh, no.
Imagine if that was true. That'd be such a great story. Like, boy, you gotta explain that one.
Yeah.
And they
really,
never do.
All that Malcolm in the Middle money, and he's being stingy over $200.
Malcolm in the Middle money.
How did you get in a position?
Matt's Malcolm in the Middle money.
He's gotta be still spending that cash, right?
Oh, God.
He's got royalties coming.
He's got a jetpack.
He's
got a jetpack, he says.
I mean, if he was smart, he invested it, or had a lawyer or parents, and I don't know.
Invested in jetpacks.
You got that right.
Tell you that much.
Wave of the future.
Damn right. Nah, and I don't want to know until I get my 200 back.
So, Frankie Muniz came by.
Man, motherfucker.
Can't buy him love?
Yes, no.
Got it.
I have a final comment.
Prove a final it. Comment. All right, I won't read mine.
Oh, oh. No. Okay.
No, go ahead. I'm joking.
Hopefully
go
it's
ahead.
The same one.
I have once before the final comment.
I was joking. Go ahead.
Johnny Two Times says, jokes aside, Al, Matt, Nikolai Seitch, you're my friend. Well, thank you, Johnny Two Times.
We're friends.
Oh,
right back.
Johnny Two Times, you're our friend too.
Right on back.
Even though you spelled Nikolai's name as Nocholai.
Well, you're not my friend then.
We know what you were saying.
I don't know.
No, I don't. I don't know what he was saying.
Who's Knockily?
But I do know he's a son of a bitch. That's how I tell the difference between my friends and my enemies. I misspell my name.
It's good.
Nicholai.
Nicholai.
You know what I do know?
What's that?
Big City living.
Oh my God!
Living
I wasn't
up
expecting
in
it.
Big motherfucking city.
Tweedly dip boop.
Gentlemen, how's Big City living?
It's good. Well, you know, whatever. Got time.
That was Big City Living.
Doodly bop bop, scoodly bop. See you later next time on Big City Living.
I don't think. I don't know if I can.
I was going to say the bird, the pigeon. What were you going to say?
That thing, the shit with the lift?
Yeah, that's fine. Because you're going to Jamaica.
The lift.
Right? Is that what you were saying?
Yeah. All right. So,
just expand sometimes. There's thousands of people.
So, I was fucking
in the streets.
I was coming home Sunday, and I was like, oh, instead of taking the bus that takes like an hour ish to get to the train, I'll just hop in a Lyft and take that because that's like 15 minutes.
Right.
So I start typing in the train station, blah, 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 and then it pops up on the thing. So I click it, and oh, little do I know, it changes the address to somewhere completely different. So he picks me up, and we're going, and then we get to a corner, and he's like, all right. I was like, what? I'm like, what's up? He's like, we're here. I'm like, where are we? Where is this?
Where is here?
I'm like, I'm supposed to go into the train station. He's like, and he showed me his phone, and it said 92nd Street. And I'm like, what? where is this?
Oh my God. That's so far.
So I got out, and I was like, all right, cool.
Here I am.
Thanks. So I looked.
Did you get in the wrong lift?
No, dude.
The address changed. Yeah, said.
Like, because the address was like 92-00 whatever street. And when I clicked on it, it changed it to 92nd Street for some reason.
Oh.
Right.
So it was like a 12, 13 minute car ride. Or a 45-minute walk. I was like, "Fuck you, dude!" So I called an Uber, and like right away, address was, came through. Perfect, no problem. When I clicked on it, and then I finally got there. I was like, "Fuck!" Oh, I was so mad.
I love that you got a Lyft and you had to call an Uber to clean up the Lyft's mess.
Yeah, right. Lyft, your trash Lyft.
I also like that your money, your time-saving idea probably cost you triple.
Dude, and it took probably so much longer because I had to stand there and wait for the Uber to get there.
You turned what was initially a 15-minute ride into a 45-minute experience.
Yeah, it was awful. It was awful. I was so mad. I was like, this is fucking terrible. God. I wanted to
You drove. So funny. You drove 15 minutes to have to be able to drive 13 minutes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, did the Lyft or Uber drivers talk to you?
No.
The first guy.
I feel like they never talk anymore.
When I got in, they were like, oh, hey, how you doing? I'm like, oh, I'm good. How you doing? And then
That was it. That's good.
They.
That's all I want.
Yeah.
That is all, literally all I want. When I went to your brother's wedding in Chicago was the last time I used Ubers, and like each driver was so fucking talkative, And the last thing I want to do is get to know a stranger.
Yeah. Oh.
I just.
Yeah, you drop me off where I need to go.
Like, I want that to be a joke, but it's not. It's not. If I don't know you, I don't want to.
Listen,
at this
point. The new millennium. I talk to all the people I want to know.
Yeah. It's the new millennium.
Yeah. It's 2020.
It has been.
The future is now.
It's the new millennium.
If I want to know you, I would find you on the internet.
Yeah, I would know you already.
Yeah.
We don't have to have this process now.
Yeah.
I'm about to be. That to be 32. I don't need more friends.
No, no. That's why dating is so odd. I just come off as an asshole. I think we're better as friends. Oh, I don't want to see you anymore either.
That's a disingenuous statement.
Oh, I know it is. I'm just making a joke. Statement. I haven't been dating.
Women just can't handle being mean sometimes.
Yeah. Well, men say that too. That saying goes both ways.
That's true. I'm
first in line to be sexist. But.
Yeah, that was kind of a sexist statement. You're right. Men do say that, but I feel like there is a much higher frequency.
Yeah, probably.
Because when men usually end things, we're big stupid grunts. We end things emotionally.
That's true.
Women are just like, let's just be civil and be done. We can still be friends. No. And men are like, you and everyone you've talked to are a whore.
I smash!
You shit on my house!
Are you guys still there?
Nope.
No. Fuck! How does that happen?
Oh,
every fucking time!
How long were you guys gone?
About 2 minutes.
Yeah, it's been a little while.
Oh, we didn't pick up.
It's been a little while.
For the jokes.
No, that's dead now.
Okay, yeah. All right. Speaking of dead, there is a dead pigeon on the roof across from us.
Did Missy do it?
No, it hit a wall or
something.
If
she did, that would be impressive.
Yeah, that'd be real impressive. No,
she is pretty impressive.
Yeah, but she can't throw a pigeon on top of a building.
I was thinking more of her climbing up there and getting a pigeon.
Nah, I was thinking her, like, chucking it, like, with her mouth, like...
Yeah!
I was in Sychus camp on that one. She went up there herself. But both are kind of funny. Like, she scaled a wall just to murder a pigeon.
Hey, sometimes you gotta get stuff done.
Yeah, you gotta get up close.
Yeah, you gotta get that.
Get that boom, boom, boom.
That was like, get that boom, boom, pow. We're very musical today, this week.
Yeah, dude.
It's for Maddie's birthday.
That's true. You're all
geez,
be part of my
Matt's
musical.
Birthday.
It's a musical birthday for Matt.
Mm-hmm.
Happy birthday.
Thanks. No, we're not going to do that. We're not going to sing happy birthday.
Why not?
Because I hate it.
Happy birthday. Okay.
I'm not singing that too.
That is such an odd... you know, one of the things I find very odd about the Happy Birthday song is there's always one or two people that start it whenever there's, like, a cake presented, but they always start it at such a slow, like, almost serial killer-like...
So you can catch on. So you're like, oh, they're on the age still.
Happy birthday. Oh, motherfucker, you're gonna murder me. Oh, no.
They want to give everybody time to catch up.
Yeah, no, I know why they do it.
but
it sounds creepy as fuck.
Yeah, if you hear that in the house alone, then...
That would be almost as creepy as, like, a child. Just any child in a horror movie always...
Well, any kid. If there was a kid in my apartment, I'd be freaking out.
I don't know. Not any child.
I would
not
the
any
fuck
child
is going
movie.
On?
The kid in... The kid, what was it, Insidious? When he was dancing?
Insidious.
Oh, when he was dancing.
Oh, yeah. The little ghost kid?
Yeah, that wasn't scary. I was like, what? They keep fucking dancing.
It was creepy until they showed him dancing and, like, not, like, vicious or angry.
Yeah, he's like, oh, look at me.
I'm dancing.
I was like, all right.
I don't know. He's having a good time. I watched The Shining at way too young of an age, and those twins fucked me up, man.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the MacReady girls?
Yeah, I don't remember their names. Good for you.
Were they MacReady? Creep girls.
Did all the twins, whenever you saw twins in school, would you get freaked out, Nikolai?
Just scream in their
face.
Yeah,
especially considering our graduating class had like 8 sets of twins.
We had a lot of twins.
We had so many twins. Even the fraternal ones, I was like,
Oh, no.
Hey, Justin.
I know that one.
I just saw you. Oh.
I just saw the lady version of you. What the fuck?
Oh, my God.
We did. We had an abnormal amount of twins in our grade. There's the water. Who knows?
Yeah. Jumps into the water.
Matt's like, I've never given it any thought, and I won't still.
Those people are still non-consequential to me.
Yeah, it's true.
Honestly, you're saying we have so many twins in our class. I'm like, yeah, we had those. That's about all I can remember.
Well, the roofer twins. Jesus.
Oh, them roofers.
They fucking scared the fuck out of me.
Yeah, they were terrifying. They always wore the same outfit from kindergarten up. It didn't fit, and it stank.
Oh, yeah, it was gross. They'd scream.
Yeah, like, cover yourselves up.
Someone needs to get these people help.
Instead of nails, they had teeth.
Whoa, what?
It's gross.
What was that?
You know what I'm realizing right now? It's very hard to transition from talking about kids in school to guns.
Well, it's just inappropriate. It's inappropriate. It's too much of a real thing.
Well, it's the roofer
to be
twins.
Joking about.
Yeah,
it's just the roofer twins.
The roofer twins, yeah, I guess. Yeah.
Well, after school, you go home to the roofer twins' house. And their house.
Then what, man?
Their house was made of guns.
My dad used those brand new AK-47 2x4s.
Yeah, I was like, oh my God, this is terrifying.
I was about to say, kids playing with guns inappropriately at their own parents' homes and then shooting themselves is a problem as well. So where are you going with this one, Al?
But you know what's not a problem? A house made of guns.
You need those walls.
I'm just imagining a house where everything's guns. Dinner is served on guns.
I had to cut this steak. Bam!
That would
it's
be
targets to turn up or down the volume on the TV.
Oh, God.
If I need a gun, happy birthday, Patrick Dempsey.
You shit on my house! You shit on my house!
You shit on my gun house!